Hey, welcome back to the Zep Pearl channel. It's me, Vance VK, your host, and this is a special episode, I guess. It's gonna be long. Sit tight. I don't think I've done one of these before, an entire collection video. But what sparked this, I went to go see Metallica, and it's the first time in 31 years since I've seen them. This would be my seventh or eighth time. Let's do the math. I think it's my seventh time seeing them. But the last time I saw them was in 1991 on the Black Album tour. So they're coming to Chicago, to Lollapalooza. And I was like, you know, I'm due. Every time they've come through, I've missed them for whatever reason. And I just thought, you know, it's time to go see them, man. Because, you know, I'm getting older. They're getting older. You just don't know, right? How long these guys are going to be touring anymore. But another reason I'm doing this is a big shout out to a fellow YouTuber, vinyl community guy, and probably the biggest Metallica fan that I know personally. I'm talking about Brett over at Headbangers Closet. Brett came up for the show and we got to meet up, and we had a great time. We met up the night before at Kuma's, which is like a, you know, burger place, bar kind of thing. And they're known for their big burgers, good food. But all the burgers are named after metal bands. Obviously Metallica, I had the Led Zeppelin. So I met Brett up there with some of his other Metallica friends, and everybody was really cool, I had a good time. And then that was Wednesday night. Thursday was Lollapalooza. Those guys got there really early. And I was able to meet up with those guys, and they were right in front of the stage. Now, unfortunately, all of a sudden, then we're hanging out, watched some pop bands, and we're just standing there talking. But then Brett got a call, or got a text or something that he could get in the snake pit. And I was just like, dude, go. Don't worry about me or whatever, man. Just go. You got it. You're able to get in the snake pit. So he got into the snake pit. So we didn't get to really hang out during the show. But it was great to at least definitely meet up with him. So here you go. I got a picture here on the phone. Check it out here. It's me and Brett over at waiting for Metallica. All right, there's a picture of me and Brett before the show. A couple of his buddies in the back there. And definitely check out the channel. It shows incredible Metallica collections. It has some kick-ass posters and stuff, and his channel is Headbangers Closet. Links in below. Please sub him up, and I'm sure he's gonna do an update of the show, and he'll probably show video. Like I said, he was in the snake pit. By the time they came on stage, I made the mistake of, you know, of course, you know, I'm like, all right, well, let me go get something to drink, and I'll, you know, use the restroom and come back, and yeah, sure enough, man, it filled up. I knew it was a chance. But then, you know, I was eyeing out some of the other side, so I went on the left side of the stage and I put up a video of my point of view, a series that I've been doing at the show. So check that out. I'll have the link below, or it's on my channel. It'll probably be uploaded with this video. But I thought, kind of in honor of seeing Metallica after 31 years, that I met Brett, you know, somebody I'd never met before. We just knew each other through YouTube and started texting and talking. And he came up to Chicago. We were able to hang out. So I'm kind of a little tribute to that. And Brett, so again, head him up. Headbangers Closet. I can't say that enough. And I'm going to do an entire Metallica collection. I mean, everything I got that I can remember that I pulled out. And some of the stuff, I tore this place apart to look for, because I'm like, where did I put this and that? So I'm talking LPs. I'm talking singles. I'm talking bootlegs, CDs, and just everything else, you know, mags and little posters and knickknacks, whatever else I got. So it's going to be a long one. Sit tight, grab a beer. We're going to kick it off, the LPs. So let's do that, man. Here's all the albums that I have from the band. All right, man, let's kick it off with the albums. The first one, Kill 'Em All. This is the Elektra pressing. Now, I don't have the Megaforce albums. Right when I really, you know, decided to... I knew of Metallica, but I didn't buy the first two albums when they were on Megaforce. I came in really where I was like, and I'll get to it, but, you know, around Ride the Lightning. And unfortunately, I got only the two Electra ones. So this is the Electra pressing. This is probably, whenever they signed to Electra and flipped them over, I had been like a late 84, 80, you know, early 85, and they and flipped it. But this is my copy from the mid 80s, I would say, you know, anywhere from 84, 85 when I picked this up. It does have the original inner sleeve and everything. So Metallica's Kill 'Em All, you know, definitely a fan favorite. It's where all began. It's a fantastic album. I also picked up the Walmart exclusive with the color. What was this one? Jumpin' the Fire Engine Red. And I haven't opened this yet. Haven't listened to it yet. See what it sounds like. I hear they're not that bad. I know Brett over at Headbangers Closet did a whole thing on some of those. And this is, yeah, this is my first copy that I picked up. Like I said, this is the Electra copy. Don't have Megaforce, man. I would love to get them, but this is the Electra edition. Probably, you know, the re-84 when they put them on Electra, 84, maybe early 85, later in the year, you know. The story on this, I think the first time I really heard this, I was doing a friend of mine that went to a different high school than me had a little, they had, their high school had a radio station. How cool is that, right? My high school didn't have that. But he had a little radio program, and we met through a vocational school. I was in TV media, and he was too. At this vocational school, we'd go off, to, you know, half of the day to. And he said, dude, why don't you come on and co-host on my radio show? So I did, and I was known as Captain Zeppelin. And he played this, and that's kind of where I got it. You know, I was like, oh, you know, I just was able to sit down and I heard it, you know, not just kind of hearsay, or because nobody was playing this stuff on the radio, at least at that time in Chicago. It wouldn't be till an underground kind of a metal station came on the scene a little around that time too. But that's where I heard it, on a high school station while I was with my friend. And I remember going doing an event. They had like a live festival or something like that in the suburbs. And we gave a couple of these away, and you know, those were probably the Megaforce copies, who knows, maybe not. But yeah, Ride the Lightning, definitely a favorite here. And we all know the songs, I'm not gonna go through them all, but yeah, I mean, Creeping Death is really what drew me in. And you know, obviously Ride the Lightning, Fire, Fire with Fire, For Whom the Bell Tolls, I mean, come on, just classic. I also picked that up on the Walmart edition. Like a turquoise, what they call this. It's electric blue vinyl. Didn't open this one either, but. And then here we, you know, this epic right here, Master of Puppets. This is the copy I got in 85. It's on Electra. And, I don't know, 85, 86, my mistake, but 86. Yeah, so those other pressings probably already fine. This would be the first time I've seen Metallica. I would see them open up for Ozzy twice, one at the UIC Pavilion and then Poplar Creek, which was an outdoor theater with Cliff. And yeah, just how can you not? I had a buddy, we had a little Mustang GT, my friend Alex, and he had the cassette, and we would just play this all the time that summer, man. It was just blasted. Another buddy of mine, Vinny, a big Metallica fan too, man. We would just crank this album. So yeah, here's the original copy that I've had since 85, again, with the inner sleeve. My Ride the Lightning has the inner tube. And then yeah, I picked that. You're gonna see a lot of these Walmarts because I picked them up. This was the limited exclusive Walmart. Battery brick vinyl. So this is on the blackened label, obviously. And then this is where it kind of cuts off for me buying records back in the day, and then CDs came in, and we'll get to that a little later. But then Metallica's the 598 EP Garage Days Revisited. This is kind of where I, you know, stopped buying the records and I went to CDs, like, in, you know, I drank the Kool-Aid. I still don't know where my head was back then, but who knew? But yeah, I picked this up. This is the original I had since when it came out. It has the Electra company sleeve. I don't think this had an inner sleeve. I could be wrong. Maybe not. You know, maybe my copy was you know, those record labels would get lazy when they didn't have enough printed up, and they would just throw that company sleeve in. If you got a company sleeve on this, let me know in the comments. But yeah, this is just, you know, just kind of a test run for Jason. You know, we lost Cliff in September of 86, I believe it was, and this is, they come back with Jason from Flotsam and Jetsam. And this was his initiation on LP. Doing cover songs like Helpless, The Small Hours, The Wait, Crash Course in Brain Surgery, Misfits Classics, Glass Crest, Green Hill. A lot of people got turned on to Misfits because of this album. They weren't into him before. So then, yeah, I didn't pick up Justice and Justice for All on vinyl until, you know, I got it on CDs and I was buying the CDs, and I don't know why I was doing that. I mean, I should have bought both. But I found recently a copy of Injustice for All. This is a Brazilian copy. Got this not too far. And this is on white wax on Vertigo. So there's the vertical swirl. And there's a label on that. So it was cool to get this. You know, I was lucky to snag one of these, a Brazilian copy of Injustice for All. I did see them on the Injustice tour. I saw them for the Monsters of Rock tour. Then they came back headlining. They played the UIC Pavilion with Queentrike, and then they came back and played Poplar Creek, the outdoor theater, with the Cult. And I'll go into those in detail when I get to those in my album and concert reviews. I did again pick up the Walmart one. This is Dyer's Green Vinyl, the Walmart edition. Again, I haven't opened these up and gotten to them, not just by not getting them. And of course, you know, I'm looking for original copies of Injustice, also looking for original copies of this, the Black album. This is the reissue 2021 on Blackened Records. Big dropping off point for a lot of people. I don't know why. A lot of people, just, you know, hardcore Metallica fans, just, you know, wasn't thrashy enough for them. But I don't know. When it came out, it was a big record. I mean, it was a new Metallica album, and it was, you know, 1991, and we all loved. I have no problems with this album. I mean, you know, Enter Sandman, yeah, sure, that's, you know, the generic song. You know, everybody knows that. That's their, quote, maybe Stairway to Heaven. I don't know. But Wherever I May Roam, Don't Tread on Me, Of Wolf and Man, Sad But True. I mean, those are some favorites. Through the Never. I mean, I like this. I still like this album, even though a lot of people don't. This is the Walmart exclusive in some blacker vinyl version. Nice reflection there. So there's that. On the Walmart version. And then a lot of these now, like I said, man, I stopped buying the records. I wish I bought original copies of these, but I didn't. So I picked up all the Walmart ones. This is Load. I haven't opened this one up yet either, but we'll get there. Garage Inc. So, you know, this one kind of gets rated up there with some of the fans in their top five. Still, you know, album covers, we all know this. This is the Walmart Fade to Blue vinyl. But some great cover versions on this, definitely. Again, in Load, this one I did open up here, play this, it sounded great. This is, again, the Walmart version. What is this, Flaming Fuel vinyl. I mean, I love the song Fuel, man. What else is a big song that I like on this one? Memory Remains is all right. Slither. But, yeah, I mean, the 90s, you know, at this time, I was buying CDs. I remember around this time, this was, what, 97? Yeah, I think I started working at I was managing a chain record store. And, you know, I had a bunch of the promo posters and stuff, and I didn't hang on to them. I wish I sold them or gave them to other Metallica friends or whatever, and I don't know why I didn't hang on to them. One reason I have a ton of posters, but I should have hung on to something of that. And here's everybody's favorite album, Saint Anger. You know, this is on Some Kind of Orange vinyl. This is the Walmart exclusive as well on Blackened. And say what you want about this album. I gave this a re-listen, and yeah, maybe the mix could be redone. It'd be interesting if they did remix this. We all know the deal with the drums coming in really tinny and too much. And, you know, obviously we know about Injustice too with the bass issues and stuff, but I don't know, give this album a listen, man. And you know, they actually, James was kind of throwing a little dig at themselves on stage at Lollapalooza, where he was kind of going, oh, St. Anger, up, down, and you know what? The crowd didn't really boo it that bad or something, you know, we're like, eh, it was kind of quiet. But they ended up playing a song, what did they play? A Dirty Window. I think I got some of that in my audio clip, so check that out. But I don't know, give it a listen again, man. I did, and the CD I popped in, and I don't think it's that, you know, it's not as hideous as, you know, like, but you know, I think I'm a fan, you know, so I don't have that. I didn't drop off after the Black Album. I was buying CDs. I just dropped off of buying records. But I still liked it all, man. Next up, when was this? This was the 2008 release of Death Magnetic. Still in the shrink, but kind of a, you know, comeback to the heavier side of Metallica, I would think. Songs like Cyanide, that was Just For Your Life, The End of the Line, I mean, good stuff here. And I thought, you know, I think it was a pretty strong album considering, and, you know, again, a lot of people, you don't bring this up, the album a lot, you know, too much. I haven't seen that, some of the other Metallica fan stuff, but give it another courtesy listen, man. Of course, I have that in the Walmart. I picked that up, and that's on a silver, magnetic silver vinyl. All right. So, the Walmart edition of Death Magnetic. And we're going to wrap it up here with the studio albums. This is the Hardwire Self-Destruct Record Store Day exclusive 2LP 180 red vinyl on this. And Hardwired to Self-Destruct. Again, man, I like this album, man. Songs like Atlas Rise, Moth Into the Flame, the tribute to Lemmy, Murder One. Listen to that song. Go look up the video of that song, man. It's a great little tribute to Lemmy. The artwork was a little odd. I don't know. Maybe, it could, you know, some people didn't like it. And I'm still kind of puzzled by it a little. But, yeah, this was on this red, kind of smoky red with a little lots of black in there, but I put this on the other day as well, and you know, I was doing my little show prep before the show, and I, you know, to me, it's a solid album, man. I don't get some of the haters out there, but whatever, to each their own. And then of course the Flame Orange Walmart edition on that. So that's the last of the studio LPs. Let's move to the compact discs now. All right, we're gonna move on to the compact disc CDs. Again, man, once, you know, obviously when CDs came out, I went back and picked up a lot of the albums, and of course I picked up Kill 'Em All. Now I'll show some of the special ones. This is the one of the earlier pressings. Because this one had Am I Evil and Blitzkrieg on the back, and then later they took that off. So, you know, look for that, man. You're looking at CDs, and see if you get those two considered bonus cuts that were off the Garage Days EP or a single. And I'll get to that soon. So, Kill 'Em All on CD. Again, this is the Elektra Ride the Lightning, but the US standard versions. Metallica's Master of Puppets, obviously, and Justice for All. Here I put some of the ticket stubs on the back at the time. So yeah, this is where I started buying CDs instead of the records, and I regret it. Wish I bought both at least, but there you go. But yeah, I used to put the tickets on the back of albums, and then I started putting them on the CDs because I didn't have to tape them, which was good. Of course, the Black Album, and yeah, this is the last time I seen Metallica in concert on that tour. Here's a cool little promo now. This is 15 pieces of Live Shit Binge and Purge promotional 2-disc set from that big, like, equipment case, kind of anvil case, that came out with videos and all that. Well, this was a 2-CD promotional set to promote that, with a little sticker on it, nothing on the back, and little CDs out here, and it had these CDs. There's disc two. You can see that there a little. So yeah, this was very cool. I was at at this time I was working in radio station, and I got that there. This promo copy still kind of in the shrink, it's falling off. I should probably because the sticker isn't on there, but I'm just using that to protect the sticker. But a nice little promo, just a little sampler of 15 pieces of live shit. And then the standard CDs, man, you know, when they came out, this is obviously Load, Reload. Here's a promotional copy of Garage Inc. with the promo sticker on there. Two album set. I don't know if it says promotional copy on the CD. It's really hard to read. I want to say it did, but maybe not because of that sticker. But hole punch in the back. And you got that, you see that they had the hypes stuck on the case, and you can see that little promotional only sticker across the front. Here's a bootleg CD called The Sandman Cometh. This is a six CD set that I picked up not too long ago, man. So I had to pick this up. It has some great shows on this, but look at this thing, man. This folds out big time. And you'll see some of these I have on vinyl too when I pick some of them up. But it's pretty, you know, it's pretty good. It was really, really inexpensive, considering a six CD set. I mean, this is covering shows from 89, 94, 91, and I think maybe even the Woodstock 94 show, some of that too. But The Sandman Cometh. Next up, this was a promotional copy of S&M. Look at the little gold stamp on the front there. This one, did it say on there as well? I don't see it, but yeah, CD, we all know that, but yeah, promo copy of that. Saint Anger on CD when it came out, you know, the big fold out, we all know these. Couple CD bootlegs. This is live at Allstate Arena, which is here in Chicago. 04, kind of a homemade kind of copy, but found it in a shop or something, so I picked it up. Not the greatest sound quality compared to some of the other ones, but this is volume two of the same show, live at the Allstate Arena. This was an interesting live album here. They played, I want to say it's Detroit. Yeah, the Motor City in 2013 under the name Dehan. Now, I'm sure Brett could tell me more about this. I didn't know anything about it, but it looked like they played the first album pretty much in its entirety. So I had to snag this. It's just a one CD set and it's kind of cardboard paper. But Motor City, and maybe this was at the Orion Festival. No, maybe not. But when did this come out? Doesn't say, but yeah. So they went under the name, you can see kind of crossed out Metallica and Dehan. Kind of, I guess, like a surprise show. The Death Magnetic with the kind of like little 3D cover that, or the, what do they call that? The embossed or whatever. And the booklets kind of like cuts through, you know, with all the little, like it sinks in kind of. So Death Magnetic on CD. Yeah, I have a copy on CD. I bought it and Lulu, putting it on the, well, Lulu, Lou Reed album. I mean, this really should just been, they shouldn't even put their name on it. They should have just kind of kept it mysterious and just done a Lou Reed album and people could have figured it out, but they went with it. And I don't know, is this probably the least favorite Metallica album, even worse than Saint Anger? But is it really a Metallica album? So that's a discussion for another day, I guess. And this is the deluxe 3D set with 14 bonus songs on it for Hardwire. Still have it in the shrink there, but I slide it out when I can. So Hardwire there. And then I recently picked this up. This is S&M 2. I didn't pick this up on vinyl. I just went with the CD. The S&Ms are cool, but it's not something I put on all the time with the symphony and everything. But you know, I had to complete the collection on the CD at least. And then this one is recent. Now, last September, Metallica does a surprise gig here at the Metro to honor, what is it? I think 40 years from when they played the Metro. Back in, well, not 40 years, but this is right when everybody was getting back after the pandemic, you know, all the shows were canceled. They come and play the Metro here in Chicago, where they played in 1983, and it's well documented in the Cliff 'Em All video, which I will show. And so they put that show on CD. I could not get into it. I was at work at the time, and it was like they announced it, and you just basically had to be standing in front of the Metro to probably get into that, unless you really knew somebody at the Metro or maybe a radio station or the band. I only know of a few people that got in there, but and they were right there, and one's a radio person. So Metallica live at the Metro, 2021, celebrating their first time they play Chicago at the Metro. So those are the CDs. Let's move on to the singles, and I'll show those next. All right, now we're going to go through the singles. We're going to include 7-inches and 12-inch singles. I'm going to start this one off with, there's a funny story with this one. This is Metallica 30. This is featuring So What Live and Through the Never Live. This came out 2017 maybe? No, 12? No, this is earlier. This was like featured in a magazine, and I can't remember if it was Metal Hammer or Classic Rock magazine, right? So it was, they did a cover story of Metallica. They included this 45 in there, and I was looking for it all over. I finally found it at Walmart, but the magazine wasn't in there. Somebody ripped off the magazine, left the 45 in the little cardboard slipcase, right? So I went and I said, this is really all I wanted. I mean, it'd been nice to have the magazine. Yeah, sure, but I really wanted this. So I took this up to the counter. I go, dude, I just want this 45. Looks like somebody ripped you guys off. He goes, the guy said, you know what? Take the 45, just leave the slipcase so we can, you know, put it in our profit and loss thing or stolen stuff or whatever. And I got this for nothing. Usually that magazine runs about 15 bucks. So yeah, so that was great. You should have seen me walking out of that store with a big smile on my face. So this is the first 30 years. This was, I believe, recorded at the San Francisco 30-year anniversary shows. And yeah, man, happy to have this 45 in the collection, especially the way I got it. Next up, unfortunately over the years, and again, I don't know what the heck I was thinking, but I had 45s for Eye of the Beholder, I believe, and One. You know, I bought those singles because the covers were cool or whatever. And somewhere in the mid-90s, tough times, I was selling stuff, and I sold a couple things that I wish I didn't. I sold some shirts. The only shirt, Metallica shirt I have this is in a Vinyl Club shirt. So I sold the my 1988 shirts that I had, and also some other 12-inch singles. I sold two 12-inch singles, I think one for, what is this one there? I want to say it was one for Sad But True and maybe Enter Sandman. And then I sold those two 45s. But these are from the Vinyl Club, Metallica Vinyl Club. And I've done individual videos on these, so you can check those out if you want to see all the details. But this was edition number one. This had For Whom the Bell Tolls and Leper Messiah. This was number one. This was number two that came out. They were releasing these quarterly, even though there were a lot of delays in it. But you can check out these videos in my... on my other videos, I did one for each release. And then this is the third one. Disappear, Leaked and Live. Again, man, pretty cool to have these. I'm glad I joined the club. And then the last 45 of that series was a tribute to Chris Cornell, which was interesting. You know, he just passed. And they did All Your Lies and Head Injury on this. And that was the fourth edition. So now I'm going to move into the 12-inch singles, and I want to say this is arguably, it's either Ride the Lightning or this, and I kind of lean to this. I think this was the first actual Metallica item I bought, and it was the Creeping Death 12-inch featuring Am I Evil and Blitzkrieg on the side. This is the, I can swear this is our Music for Nations, and I think this is the... this is the first thing, because Creeping Death, I was all into that. And then I think we were playing Am I Evil somewhere, either one of the VBX, WVBX, the radio station was playing, or then I got sucked into that. I don't know, VBX, yeah, that's around 84. And that song, you know, so main reason I got this was for those two songs, and then I'm a good 90% sure I bought this, and then I bought Ride the Lightning for the rest, because, you know, obviously these two tracks weren't on there. So I want to say this is the first Metallica album I picked up. It was the 12-inch single, Creeping Death on Music for Nations. Next up, I have an import single here. This is The Unforgiven from the Black album. Main reason I got this was for the band, for the song So What. And like I said, I had other 12-inch singles like this, but I didn't sell this one because I wanted that. And this is on Vertigo. This is, I believe, a UK pressing. Yeah, I bought this mainly for So What. I just thought that song was hilarious. And, you know, seen them play it live. You know, it's kind of a fan favorite. But this is for The Unforgiven, and it also included Killing Time, and then a demo version of Unforgiven too. But man, I wish I kept those other. I had two others. I want to say it was Sad But True and Enter Sandman. I don't know why I did that. What are you gonna do? I picked this up. This was a Record Store Day thing, if I remember correctly, and I haven't opened this up yet. I don't know why, but Beyond Magnetic, first time on vinyl, is on silver wax. This came out 2011. It was kind of a supplement to a Death Magnetic album. So I have this. I just haven't played it. I haven't opened it up. I was keeping it sealed. Just haven't got to it. A lot to listen to, man. We'll move into the latest in the vinyl club. They're doing 12-inch singles now. And two of them were released. We're expecting the third one maybe this fall, hopefully like October. And then the last one probably in December, hopefully, if they're on time. This was the first one, number 5 in the series, Black in 2020, which included a copy of them doing it on the, I think it was the tribute to Alice in Chains, was it, at the Mopop store? Maybe I'm wrong on that. But, yeah, I think I'm wrong on that. No, they cover Wood on this. They do the Alice, yeah, I'm right. So they covered the song Wood, Alice in Chains song, on this one for the tribute to Alice in Chains from the Mopop Museum store in Seattle, which I've been to. It's pretty cool. So these were cool. And like I said, I did full videos on these. So check those out if you want to see all the cool stuff inside. This was the most recent one, and I thought this was pretty damn good. That's why I had to give Saint Anger another chance. This is 12-inch single number 6 of the series for the Vinyl Club. And this is Saint Anger Live Rarities. These were from 2004, and they had 4 tracks on it, so they packed this one up pretty good. So check that out too. That video is in my video on the page. And then lastly, I'm going to throw this in here for the 12-inch singles and stuff. But I'm going to put this in here. This is Kurt Hammett, released on Record Store Day, and this was Portals. Is kind of a solo album, and I heard that Kurt wants to get into doing soundtracks and stuff, maybe like horror soundtracks. So that'd be cool. This came out on like a turquoise vinyl, but Portals from Kurt Hammett, pretty interesting. I mean, it's not, you know, it's a different style, but I like that he's doing some cool stuff. I'd be curious to hear him do a soundtrack. All right, so those are the. Those are the 45s and the 12-inch singles or whatever I got. Now we're going to move to the bootlegs and what I have on vinyl for bootlegs. So let's check those out. Okay, now the bootlegs. A lot of these are those FM broadcasts that I've been really getting into over the last couple of years. And some other odds and ends, but let's just get into it here on the bootlegs. This is Metal Up Your Ass, and if anybody knows, this is really what they wanted that first album to be instead of Kill 'Em All, with this artwork. But from what I understand, this is some demos and the original version of Metal Massacres on this. Not Metal Massacre, the original of, I think, Hit the Lights is on this. Track 8. That was on that, you know, that mix that was on Metal Master was a little different mix on it. But some odds and ends from the first album. Very cool. This is on Lime Green, Music for Nations. Now, I don't know, you know, this might be a pirate copy and they got the Music for Nations label. But I found this not too long ago. I think I found this out in Champaign, actually, the shop out there. But glad to have it, man. It's pretty cool. Love to hear stuff like that. Next up, No Life Till London. Found this online, and this is from 1984. Cliff doing the this would be Ride the Lightning tour. Tracks on that. And I don't think there's any. This is like on an orange wax. Little spots of black in there, but not a bad sounding bootleg at all. I dig the artwork there. No Life to London. Pretty cool, man. Cliff, yours. You know, what would have happened if Cliff was still around? I don't know, man. I don't know. This is a pretty cool one. This was Masters of Metal. This is when they're opening up for Ozzy. This would be, that tour when I saw them. This is out of Chattanooga. This is a colored edition. It was limited, had a inner sleeve, nice inner sleeve on this. And who did this? This is the Discaton. If you see bootlegs by these guys, they do a real nice job. And this was a limited edition color. This is on bone white. And they only, they pressed on white 600 of those. Where is it? And then I have, there it is. 181 out of 600. A decent sounding album. Like I said, man, this Discaton does a nice job. I think I have a one or two other bands on this. But very cool to have this. 86 show out of Chattanooga. They're supporting Ozzy. This is through the soundboard. And John Marshall plays rhythm guitar on this show. Well, I guess James hurt his arm on a skateboarding accident. This is a show you had to fill in today. So there you go on that. This is what's been playing this whole time. This is the Japan broadcast, 1986. November, about what? 2 months almost after Cliff died. You know, Jason just jumped right into the fire. So this is a two album set. Pretty good sound recording. You tell me, I've been playing that throughout this whole video. This is Reunion Arena, 1989, Dallas, and FM broadcast. Another good one. This is on Mind Control. Two album set on this. I don't think it's colored. No, it's just on black. There's a label on that. Again, this is the Justice Tour. I mean, you know, they're just finding their way, getting back. So, nice to have this. Look for that. It's a decent sounding one as well. Welcome Home, live in London, 86. This one, they screwed up because it's like they got Jason on the cover, right? And then they have a picture of Cliff on the back. Maybe it was in tribute or what. But they got two pictures of Cliff. It might have been in tribute, but I kind of wish they'd stick to the things. But it's on a little black label there. Kind of reminds you of the Megaforce label. But London 86 doesn't give too much other info on it, but very kind of snag it. This is probably the newest one in the collection because I haven't opened this yet either, man. I got some Metallica listening to do. This is from Cape Girardeau, Missouri, 1986, live at the Arena Building. And I haven't listened to this. This is on Pastone Mira. Never heard that, so we'll see how this is. I just haven't pulled this out, but this is, 86 with Cliff still. Here are the tracks. I'm gonna give that a listen. I'm gonna pull that aside. All right, and then Harvester of Sorrow Limited on a clear vinyl. This is from the 1991 Moscow broadcast. Remember that that show in Moscow? I think Motley Crue was on that, and Cinderella and some others. There's a yellow copy of this. What do they call it? Scorpions, I think, were on it. Moscow Peace thing or something like that. But this is a couple tracks, you know, not the full set, I don't think, but a couple tracks from that. This is on Coda Records. And, you know, this Coda Records does a nice job on the things. They just have terrible shipping, man, because this thing got rabbit-eared and had a seam split on it, and they did nothing about it. I was kind of ticked. I mean, it's overseas, but I didn't think I was going to order anything else from them. I do have some other things here, but after that, I was really a little annoyed. So this is a 1984 live at Winston Farms in Saugerties, New York. This is 94, so what are we talking? What do they have on here? I don't have anything from Load. But two album set. This sounds really good. I guess this is an MTV broadcast. Oh, this might be from the Woodstock show as well. This is on Dole.
Yeah.
Bright orange vinyl on this, but this is a pretty decent recording as well. Yeah, I want to say that Socrates, I think that's the 94 Woodstock festival. So cuts from that. I don't know. I have to go back and look and see if this is the full set. So they're still touring the Black Album by that time. Okay, this is another bootleg I got from that Coda. This is the first edition of 2000. I got number 1386. This is Justice for All. A little 12-inch, or not, what are these? These are, these are, what are they, like 78s, like little mini, 10-inch records on Blue Wax, little 10-inch. Splattered with some black in there. And these are from the Woodstock show as well. Yeah, I know, I doubled up a little, but this was pretty cool, so I had to snag these, I thought. I mean, like I said, this Coda was doing some cool things, and unfortunately, you know, they messed it up on the shipping, but check them out, man. Just tell them to make sure they box it up right and not some little flimsy thing. But this is pretty cool, man. Justice for All, a 2 10-inch set, Metallica. And then this was kind of like a companion to that. And it's the last one I got here in the bootlegs. Limited edition on blue vinyl, Justice for All as well. And this is like just selections of that. There's more songs on the 10-inch one. But this is on there. And this is like a blue wax, like I said. A little marble to it as well. So that does it for the bootlegs. So what did we go through? We went through LPs. We went through CDs. We went through the singles. Now I'm going to show you all the miscellaneous stuff I got. Odds and ends, just stuff that I went through the place and trying to remember what I have in Metallica. So let's get into those. All right. So now we're going to show you some other stuff I have. Just odds and ends of stuff that I have from Metallica. We'll start off with some pins, man. This I got at the Justice shows. This is what they know as Doris, the Justice on the cover, Metallica. It has one of those metal pewter pins or whatever. So, got that. And I also picked this up at the same show, but the Metallica, where it said Metallica, broke off. But this is, I believe, Brain Damage. And, the Metallica thing, I don't know, it broke off. I don't know what happened. A little disappointed about that. And then I just have this plain, this Metallica, the logo one. You know, just a little pin back. So those are some the only pins I have. I have a videotape of Cliff 'Em All. Picked this up as soon as it came out. And, has that Metro show on from Chicago. At this time, this was like rare footage, man. You know, we didn't, Metallica didn't do videos like MTV stuff until one. And, this was like gold when this came out, man. Just live footage from shows. And now you can find all these, I believe, on YouTube, of course. But, you know, the old videotapes, man, this was it. Next up, I got some books. Here's a hardcover of Birth, School, Death, the biography of Metallica by Paul Branigan and Ian Winward. I believe I got this from work, so I don't think I've read this one yet. I know I read the other one, but hardcover of that. This is the one I read, Into the Black, The Inside Story of Metallica, 1991 to 2014. And what's cool about this is a promotional book. It is an advanced reading and not for resale. See if you can zoom in on that. Maybe you can, I don't think it's going to focus, but that little button, that little it's a not for sale kind of promotional thing. So this is kind of like uncorrected page proofs. So it's just kind of, you know, again, I got this from where I work, and very cool, kind of a neat, you know, you don't see how many people have promotional books, Metallica, I don't know. There was that was something for that other video that's going around. And I also have, actually, on the hardcover, I have the promotional copy of Birth School Metallica Death. Same thing there, has that uncorrected page proofs. Doesn't have, I don't think it has any of the pictures in there. It's just, this is like an advanced copy, you know, for people to do reviews on and stuff like that. So, very cool, man. I have two Metallica promotional books. Again, man, it's kind of neat to have. All right, let's go into, I'm with the stickers, man. I got two stickers, not a lot. This is from WBAB, and I want to say this is for the Nassau Coliseum. This is from 1991. Well, why? Because you can see the stamp on there. There's also the advertisement on the back Record Square World Circle. Square Circle? I don't know. Advertisement for the Black Album on the back. But you see this in some of my videos, Metallica. This is probably to promote the show that they were going to do at the NASA Coliseum. And then when Hardwire came out, I got some stuff from them. This was a sticker. I got a bunch of these, actually. Hardwire promotional stickers. New album available today. So I have a bunch of these still. I have there's like a little promo poster they put out. I got a good stack of these, too. I got these from the record store for Hardwire. And, you know, available now. A little promo poster for that. And then I also got this. And this is actually what I was tearing my place up to try to find last night. But this is a mask. Blah! This is a mask promoting, I guess, Atlas Rise, too. They had a code on the back here for Atlas Rise, and it was a promotional thing. And, I don't know. How many of you guys got this? Brad, I'm sure you probably got one of these, right? This little promotional mask, there's the thing there, you know, put that on your head. I put it on maybe once or twice. If I find that video, I should put it in here. A little promotional mask for Hardwire Self-Destruct. And not too long ago, I think was it last year or the year before, they put out this tribute. The Black Album came out, a reissue, and they did this tribute album with all these different artists. And I got this two-sided poster from the record store. I didn't buy that. I just bought the Black Album. I think that's when I got it. But I didn't get the 53 artists covering songs from the Black Album. I'm curious on how many Metallica fans actually got that. I mean, was it something of interest for them? I don't know. To me, it's been a little overlord. Overboard on that. 7 LP, 4 CD set for that. But I got this. So I think this side's pretty cool, actually. What else? I got there's a laminate that I got when Hardwire came out at the record store, Black and Friday. Metallica, a little laminate. It's cool. And then let's get into some of the mags. This one is probably all cut up inside. Yeah, it sure is. But I still have the cover for this. I want to say this is September 93. Metallica on the cover of Hit Parader. I have this magazine, but yeah, man, I probably cut pages up. Who knows what the heck I did, but posted them up at work, I think. I wasn't thinking. And so Hit Parader, Metallica on the cover from 93. This is the program I got from the Black Album Tour in 1991. I went to the show at the Rosemont Horizon. Here's the tour program. I kind of was in a program kick around that time. I was buying more programs than I was t-shirts. I don't think I bought a Black Album t-shirt. I don't know. I was buying programs. I don't know, man. So I'd like to get a time machine and go kick myself and say, dude, buy more stuff. But, the Black Album tour program. You can see the snake on there. From the 91 tour. This is a Spin magazine that I've had since 91. Metallica, Who's Laughing Now? On Spin. I had the Rolling Stone one, but I put that together for my cousin. interesting story. He was a bouncer, of all things, at a strip club in Peoria. When Metallica kicked off the Black Album tour in 91, they played Peoria, and he was working security of the show. And so he got to see him, but he was just kind of working security. And but he also got a couple of the green Metallica guitar picks. So I took that Rolling Stone cover, because it was from 91, and I put he got their autographs at the strip club, on the back of one of the menus or whatever at the strip club. So he got all their autographs, and I put that in a frame for him. I took the Rolling Stone cover, I took the autographs and the two green guitar picks, and they signed it, his name is Kevin, and they signed it to him. So I for years I had that, and I finally got it done and gave it to him as a gift. Even though it was his, I kind of got it framed and everything for him. And it's up in his office, I think, or something like that. But Spin Magazine, this is, like I said, from 91. Remember Spin, man? I don't know, Spin's still around. Some of these rags, you know. I don't know. And then we'll wrap it up here with a couple mats. I got this. This is a slip mat from Hardwire when the album came out. They're giving a bunch of swag, obviously. And the last thing I got here is one for when they did the Black, reissue Black Album, one for Metallica as well. So if you stuck through this whole thing, man, I don't even know what this is going to clock into, maybe close to an hour or so, 45. That's my entire Metallica collection. 99% sure everything I got that has to do with Metallica. It's not massive. Like I said, my buddy Brett over at Headbangers Closet, you just look at his videos. I mean, he has posters in the back. He has the blackened bourbon and just all kinds of cool stuff. And I think he's going to be doing a room tour soon because he got a new space for his stuff. And he's always showing some killer items. He has all those hard-to-find stuff, you know, Megaforce ones and some other cool bootlegs and stuff too. So definitely subscribe to his channel. I hope you guys stuck through that. It's kind of like I said, when we started, kind of a celebration seeing Metallica after 31 years. Crazy at Lollapalooza, which actually the only other Lollapalooza I went to was 30 years ago. I went to the 92 Lollapalooza. So yeah, it was an interesting day. I posted footage up from the show. It's all shaky because I'm out in the crowd, man. And it's no pro shot. So check that out. It's definitely my point of view. And thanks for tuning in, hanging out here at the Zeppelin Hanger featuring Metallica and everything I got. Take care, everybody. All right, we clear, Jerry? We clear? All right, good. All right. Whew. Man, hey, Jerry, thanks for helping me out. I know it's... you've been busy with the Grown Man Record Night show, but thanks for coming up and helping me out. Now I got to put all this stuff away, and I'm really glad you're here to help me. Jerry? Son of a bitch. Where did he go?